بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. ربي اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. Brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Learn Arabic grammar the easy way. We will learn three words or حروف إلى مع and عند. We learn through TPI. And what is TPI? Can you show it? Hear it, see it, think it.
Hear it, see it, think it.
Say it, show it,
say it, show it, love it.
Together.
Do it together.
We have learned that Arabic words are of three types: ism, fi'l, and harf. Again,
ism, fi'l, and harf.
And we are learning huruf, the third category. No, la, min, or li, min, an, bi, fi, ala. And here today also we will learn three more. So what did we learn in the last lesson? Bi, fi, and ala. And these, along with he, him, ka, e, kum, na, and ha, occur in the Quran 3400 times. MashaAllah, 3401. Can you give me meanings and example of these three? Bi, in. Bismillah, fi, in. Fi sabilillah, ala, on. Assalamu alaikum, mashallah. Bi means in. Can you translate? Be he?
In him.
Be him?
In them.
Be ka?
In you.
In you. Be?
In me.
In me. Become?
In you all.
Bina?
In us. Us.
Repeat after me. Be he? Be him?
Be he? Be him?
Be ka? Be?
Be ka? Be?
Become? Bina.
Become bina.
Fi means in. Fi sabilillah. Translate. Fihi.
In him.
Fihim.
In them.
Fika.
In you.
Fiya.
In me.
Fikum.
In you all.
Fina.
In us.
After me. Fihi. Fihim.
Fihi. Fihim.
Fika. Fiya.
Fika. Fiya.
Fikum. Fina.
Fikum fi now.
MashaAllah. And the last that we learned in the last lesson is ala, on. Assalamu alaikum. Okay, now translate. Alayhi.
On him. On him.
Alayhim.
On them.
Alayka.
On you.
Alayya.
On me.
Alaykum.
On you all.
Alayna.
On us.
After me. Alayhi. Alayhim.
عليه
عليه عليك علي
عليك علي
عليكم علينا
عليكم علينا
ما شاء الله. We are learning the words that occur in the Quran thousands of times, and he, him, ka, e, kum, na is the same. We just have learned repeated three, bi, fi, ala. Similarly, we will take only three words, and he, him, ka, e, kum, na, that will be attached, and ha. So in today's lesson, well, we have to say we have divided every lesson into small units for practice breaks. So the first unit, I'll say Alhamdulillah, we are learning. In this lesson, we will learn ila, ma'a, and inda, three prepositions, just three new words. The rest is all the same. He, him, ka, e, kum, na, and ha. So let's take the first preposition. Ila. Ila means to. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. That is the best example. Indeed, we are for Allah, and indeed, we are to return to Him. Ilayhi means to Him. Raji'un, those who will return. Those who will return. So, ilayhi raji'un. Just remember this part. Ilayhi raji'un. To Him are returners. Or to Him, we will return. So, ila means to. Example, ilayhi raji'un. Now we will use ilayhi ilayhim to point towards people. So can you translate ilayhi
to him,
ilayhim
to me, to them,
ilayka
to you,
ilayya
to me,
ilaykum
to you all,
ilayna
to us.
Once more, ilayhi
to him,
ilayhim
to them,
ilayka
to you,
ilayya
to me,
ilaykum
to you all,
ilayna
to us.
MashaAllah. Now repeat after me in Arabic only, thinking what you are saying. Okay, ilayhi ilayhim,
ilayhi ilayhim,
ilayka ilayya,
ilayka ilayya.
In fact, you can close your eyes if you want, you know, to focus on the meanings, but don't miss the actions. Ilaykum ilayna,
ilaykum ilayna.
Once again, ilayhi ilayhim,
ilayhi ilayhim,
ilayka ilayya,
ilayka ilayya,
ilaykum ilayna,
ilaykum ilayna.
MashaAllah. Can you do it with me slowly?
Ilayhi ilayhim,
ilayka
ilayya,
ilaykum ilayna. Again,
ilayhi ilayhim,
ilayka
ilayya,
ilaykum
ilayna.
MashaAllah. Allim. Alhamdulillah. Let's take unit 2. Let's take another second preposition, which is ma'a. Ma'a means with. And the best example, which is often repeated, is inna allaha, indeed Allah is ma'a sabirin, with those who are patient. Ma'a means with. Ma'a means with. Example, inna allaha ma'a sabirin, indeed Allah is with those who are patient. So ma'a means with. So ma'ahu means with him. Translate with actions, please. Ma'ahu,
with him. With him.
Ma'ahum,
with them. With them.
Ma'aka,
with you.
With you. Ma'i,
with me. With me.
Ma'akum,
with you all.
Ma'ana,
with us.
With us. Again, ma'ahu,
with him.
Ma'ahum,
with them.
With them. Ma'aka,
with you. With you.
Ma'i,
with me.
With me. Ma'akum,
with you all.
Ma'ana,
with us.
Repeat after me in Arabic only. Ma'ahu, ma'ahum.
Ma'ahu, ma'ahum.
Ma'aka, ma'i.
Ma'aka, ma'i.
Ma'akum, ma'ana.
Ma'akum, ma'ana.
Again. Ma'ahu, ma'ahum.
Ma'ahu, ma'ahum.
Ma'ahum. Ma'aka, ma'i.
Ma'aka, ma'i.
Ma'i. Ma'akum, ma'ana.
Ma'akum, ma'ana.
Ma'ana. MashaAllah. Can you repeat with me now?
Ma'ahu, ma'ahum. Ma'aka, ma'i.
Ma'akum,
ma'ana.
MashaAllah. Again.
Ma'ahu, ma'ahum.
Ma'aka,
ma'i.
Ma'akum,
ma'ana.
MashaAllah. Allim. Alhamdulillah. Let's take the last one, which is inda. It's not a preposition, it's a harf. Anyway, inda means with. And I don't have an example, simple example from the Quran, so I used a spoken Arabic sentence, which is, if you are in market and asking for a change, so you will say, come, how much? Riyal, riyal, you know, riyal. Indaka, with you. Kam riyal indak? How many riyals do you have? So with are you have? Anyway, with you, how many riyals with you? Like my friend said, ma indi riyal, don't ask me, no riyals. Anyway, inda means with. Ma means with, inda means with. But don't worry, with has many meanings. Similarly, here they keep changing. So as of now, just take inda means with. Can you translate with actions? Indahu,
with him. Him.
Indahum,
with them.
With them. Indaka,
with you.
With you. Indi,
with me.
With me. Indakum,
with you all.
You all. Indana,
with us.
Again. Indahu,
with him. With him.
Indahum,
with them.
With them. Indaka,
with you.
With you. Indi,
with me.
With me. Indakum,
with you all.
With you all. Indana,
with us.
Us. Now repeat after me only in Arabic. Indahu, indahum.
Indahu, indahum.
Indaka, indi.
Indaka,
indaka.
Indi.
Indi. Indakum, indana.
Indakum, indana.
Indana. again. Indahu, indahum.
Indahu, indahum.
Indahum. Indaka, indi.
Indaka, indaka, indi.
Indi. Indakum, indana.
Indakum, indana.
Indana. Now repeat with me. Slowly. Indahu,
indahum. Indaka, indi. Indakum, indana.
MashaAllah. Once again.
Indahu, indahum. Indaka, indi. Indakum, indana.
MashaAllah. Allim. Alhamdulillah. Let's take spoken Arabic for this inda. We can ask, does he have pen or is with him pen? Which means, does he have pen? You will say yes. Naam, indahu qalam. All of us have pens, inshallah. So, hal indahu qalam is with him pen. You say naam. Yes, indahu with him qalam, a pen, or he has a pen. So, for he has, we use indahu. Anyway, can you answer me in Arabic? Hal indahu qalam?
Naam.
Naam. Indahu qalam. Hal indahum qalam?
Naam.
Indahum qalam. MashaAllah. Once more. Answer me. Hal indahu qalam?
Naam.
Indahu qalam. Hal indahum qalam?
Naam. Indahum
qalam. Allim. Now when it comes to you and me, it is ka-i, and you all kum and na-az. Can you repeat after me or repeat with me three times? Ka-i,
kum,
na,
ka,
ka-i,
kum,
na,
ka,
ka-i,
kum,
na,
mashallah.
So, indaka, indi, indakum, indana. Now answer me in Arabic. Indaka will become indi, indakum will become indana. هل عندك قلم؟
نعم
عندي قلم. هل عندكم قلم؟
نعم
عندنا قلم. Once again. هل عندك قلم؟
نعم
عندي قلم. هل عندكم قلم؟
نعم
عندنا قلم. علم. الحمد لله. We have learned, you know, ربيه ربيها. Okay. We just want to say he. So ربه ربها. But if it is ربي, it is he. But here it is ها, stays the same. Anyway, we have learned فيه فيها عليه عليها. Similarly, إليه إليها. معه معها. Indahu, indaha. We are focusing on ha. So, can you give me the ha forms, attached forms? Ilayhi.
Ilayha.
Ilayha. Ma'ahu.
Ma'aha.
Ma'aha. Indahu.
Indaha.
Indaha. Again, ilayhi.
Ilayha.
You know why ilayhu is not there? Ilayhu, saying ilayhu is different, difficult. So, they make it ilayhi. They made it ilayhi. As simple as that. Okay, give me the forms. Ilayhi.
إليها
معه
معها
عنده
عندها
last time إليه
إليها
معه
معها
عنده
عندها
علم. ما شاء الله, we have learned إليه إليهم إليك إليا إليكم إلينا إليها معه معهم معك معي معكم معنا معها عنده عندهم عندك عندي عندكم عندنا عندها. You should practice like this, and that occurs in the Quran almost 1,100 times, 1,100 times. Okay, almost. Alhamdulillah. Now give me the meanings and example. The last exercise of every, you know, lesson to enforce us in us the meanings and examples. So, ila means to. Example.
إليه راجعون.
You can take only small part of that. Ma'a,
with.
Inna Allah ma'a as-sabirin. Inda,
with.
Kam riyal indak? Again. Ila.
To.
Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Ma'a.
With.
Inna Allah al-Sabirin. Inda.
With.
Kam riyal indak. Now give me the meanings only. Ila.
To.
Ma'a.
With.
Inda.
With.
Ila.
To.
Ma'a.
With.
Inda.
With.
Ila.
To.
Ma'a.
With.
Inda.
With.
Reverse. Inda.
With.
Ma'a.
With.
Ila.
To.
Again. Inda.
With.
Ma'a.
With.
Ila.
To.
No random. Ma'a.
With.
Ila.
To.
Inda.
With.
MashaAllah. Okay, and lastly, give me the TPI signs for these words. And don't show them unless I say. Think about them first. So first one. Ilayhi. Think. Ilayhi. Show. Ilayhi. To him. Ma'ana. Think. Ma'ana. Show. Ma'ana. With us. Indaka. Think. Indaka. Show. Indaka. With you. Now let's take learning tip. How to revise. What is the revision system? In the last lesson, you have learned how the brain forgets. That is, if you learn 100 things, you will forget 70% of them in 1 hour. You revise after 1 hour, 70% are gone next day. You revise next day, 70% are gone next week, next month, next semester. So, let us see how we can retain or not forget what we learn. If you do not want to forget, then your revision, your first revision should be after 1 hour. The second revision after 1 day. The third revision after 1 week. The fourth revision after 1 month. And fifth revision after 6 months. This is a general, you know, kind of suggestion by the researchers. But we have a more specific and practical suggestion. But there may be a question. How much time should I study? How much time should I give for revision? So here is another suggestion by the researchers. They say that for every hour of study today, you need to revise for 10 minutes tomorrow or after 1 hour, after 1 day, whatever. For every hour, you need to spend 10 minutes. So if you have studied for 3 hours today, you should spend at least 30 minutes for revision. To implement this for learning the Quran, we have introduced 7 types of homework. Of course, everything starts with dua, Rabbi zidni ilma. And all of these types of homework are absolutely easy and practical. And everyone can do it, inshallah. And we have already been talking about them. And we'll talk after this, which is by the end of this lesson, 7th lesson, we have learned 80 words which occur in the Quran almost 26,100 times. Don't forget the 7 homework. These are the 7 homework, 7 types of homework. What are they? 2 on tilawa. That's something we should be doing anyway. So recite for at least 5 minutes from the mushaf and 5 minutes while walking, going to masjid, going to office, coming back or ironing the clothes or cooking or doing anything which is not occupying your brain. So 2 on tilawa from the mushaf, from the memory. 2 on study. At least spend 10 minutes on the textbook of this course or workbook. This is the only homework, so to say, in this course of 10 minutes study. And so study from the book and from the vocabulary sheet. That is not a real homework. It's a question of attitude. You know, just carry this vocabulary sheet always with you and refer to it at different times of the day, especially before Salah or after Salah, for at least half a minute. And then the 3 homework are listening to that compact recording, concise recording, talking about the course to your friends, colleagues, teach them maybe 1 verse meanings, Qul huwallahu ahad, things like that, and recite different surahs in Salah. And 2 du'as, Rabbi zidni ilma, and O Allah, help us to learn the Quran in Quran class. And the best formula to learn is to teach. Download the PPTs, watch the video 3-4 times and teach. Or play the video, pause it every 5 minutes and practice and then continue. Or teacher's training is also available at understandquran.com. May Allah help us to recite, understand, ponder, implement, propagate, and memorize the Quran. وجزاكم الله خير. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. السلام عليكم. Learn to read Al-Quran, learn Tajweed, understand Al-Quran and memorize it using easy, scientific and interactive methods. Get ebooks, videos, audios, posters, PowerPoint files, app links for different courses. We have specialized Montessori materials and games for making the Quran easy for kids and a teacher's resource center too. Get personalized one-to-one online courses that suit your needs from expert teachers. For free trial, write to admin@understandquran.com or visit understandquran.com. Wassalamu alaikum.